in this film, I wanted to bring the audience on my journey and allow them to see how my camera sees without overwhelming them with a lot of montage and a lot of tricks to make them feel in sort of an artificial construction.
Well, it's not a demonstration.
No. It's an immersion. I mean, I really love a kind of cinema where you are allowed to look at things and give the audience time to watch things and absorb them in non-intellectual ways, in ways that are feelings, because I think that the audience knows that there's a lot of problems. And I think the audience does not want to be just overwhelmed with problems, but they also want to see things that they don't experience every day. And you know, those the nature in the film was really important to me. But I was shooting in my style. I'm not shooting in a style that is like perfect shots, because for me it was like, you know, taking the audience with me through the camera as I'm looking at it. So sometimes the camera shakes, but there was always a lot of tension around me. And the tension was the kind of tension that happens when you're not sure where you are or what's going on, and something may happen. And I have to be aware that if something does happen, I have to film it. And because there's a lot of things that you don't see that I cut out. Like for instance, in the big scene at the end of the film, where there's a confrontation between the farmers and the man from Chevron, the head of Chevron for Poland, there's something that happened in that meeting which was really interesting. And that is that the translator for that meeting, who's translating from English to Polish and Polish to English, that translator worked for Chevron, and he was not translating properly to the farmers. So as I'm filming, I'm hearing that the translation is not proper, so I interrupted the meeting, and I would say, well, this is what this man said, and I translated for the Polish people, and said, here's what they're saying. And this changed the dynamic in a meeting, and suddenly, this was a real interesting problem for me, because the problem was, do I get involved with the scene as a filmmaker, or do I stand back and let this happen? But at this point in my life, I have no interest in just being a nice documentary filmmaker. So I got involved with them by saying to them, okay, this is what's going on, this is what they're talking about. And it was a conscious, I remember thinking about, okay, what do I do? Do I get involved now, or do I stand back and just let this happen? And my decision was that it's more important to create a truth, because by the farmers knowing what was really being said, it changed the whole dynamic of the meeting. And the meeting was supposed to be an hour and a half long. The meeting ended up being almost 4 hours long, because it became a very big discussion. And it made me not necessarily a militant filmmaker, but it made me more, it made me realize that the truth is very important, and the truth is not just the camera being there. You, as a filmmaker, I think you can get involved and still capture a scene in a way that is very honest and very cinematic. I mean, these are difficult questions, because at the end of the day, what I'm also really interested in aesthetics, and the aesthetics are something that there are several layers of information. There's the information that you learn that's intellectual, but there's also the information that you learn from the filmmaker by the way the filmmaker frames something, where the camera position is, the rhythm of the scene. There's a lot of forms of information that together make an aesthetic, and you have to be aware of all of them so that the film is not just a way to present information. The film is a way to present a society or a reality that is. An interpretation by the filmmaker of what's going on, and not just like a copy that you get on a copy machine.